are going through tough times, if you are going through like a lot of troubles in all areas of your life, and you just have this deep feeling inside that says that this is all because of your past life karmic issues. So if you at all feel that, your number one question may be, how do you heal those issues? Hi, I am Preeti and you are watching this video on how to heal your karmic issues. Because I do get this question a lot, so we are going to talk about this. So make sure that you watch this video till the end so that you get the entire scoop. Okay, stay tuned. So you may have heard about these words, heal your karmas, erase your karmas, let me help you to remove your karmic baggage, remove your negative karmic baggage. You may have heard about all of this. If you have heard, then let me know in the comments below. So just if you have heard about all of this stuff, your number one question may be, okay, how do I do that? So let's understand a story, a little bit of story about a man. This man was a server, okay? He was a person who used to serve food in a canteen, in a school canteen. Okay, so this man, as soon as he turned 30 years old, he ended up with this job in a school canteen, where he had to serve food to the students, small, younger students, elder students, all below the age of 18 years. So he had this job, and in his job, he used to do one wrong thing, one partiality he used to do with the students. There used to be some students who used to be from Sri Lanka. Okay, now this is just a made up story, this is not a real story, and this is just to help you understand karma and how to heal those issues. I don't have any personal issues with Sri Lankans or with anybody, this is just a made up story. So what he used to do is, he used to be partial towards Indian people and people from any part of the world. And he used to discriminate a little bit about Sri Lankans. He used to be an Indian and he did not like Sri Lankans because that's the place of Ravan. Okay, now let me tell you, people of Sri Lanka, they actually worship Ravan. So what this man used to do, anybody whom he felt had the origin from Sri Lanka, he actually used to serve less food, lesser quality food, any food stuff that used to be good, he used to always offer it a little less to the Sri Lankans because he did not like Ravan. Ravan was from Sri Lanka. Okay, now see, definitely this is a wrong thing, okay, because Ravan, he did some bad stuff, but because of that you're not supposed to punish the entire culture of that state, of that country. So what used to happen is, the children from Sri Lanka, they always felt devoid. The best of the dishes in the canteen, whenever it was feasting time, whenever it was Christmas or any other festival, there used to be the bestest of food items, and this guy, he used to always keep the Sri Lankans devoid of those good foods. So what happened then? His entire life he did that till the age of like 60, till he retired. And then he resumed with his normal life. Now in the next birth, this man is born in Sri Lanka, and just because he did that, you know, he did a lot of discrimination with Sri Lankans and towards other pupils of the school. He was born in Sri Lanka, and now what happens is that he is kept devoid of all the good things. Yeah, till he was 30 years old, nothing happened. But then as soon as he turned 30, he is kept devoid of all good things in his life. The girl that he likes, just this much of effort was needed. And just before applying that much effort, that girl actually escapes from his touch. She just vanishes and goes and marries somebody else. The job that he likes, the best of jobs, he has good education, but as soon as he is going to end up with a good job, that job is given to someone else. Same thing applies with money also, with the good amount of money, good amount of salary that he was going to have, promotion he was going to have. The moment that decision of promotion is about to be taken, just at the last very teeny tiny bit of moment, he actually loses it. So this happens to him for like 60 years, from 30 years to 60 years. Why? Because he did that same thing in his past birth with other people. Now, let me tell you, with this kind of thing, see, even you feel that little children are so innocent, and discriminating one child from another, keeping one child devoid of some good feasting food items just because that child is born in a different country. How does that feel to you? It feels definitely wrong. You never want that thing happens either to you or your kids. So you ask yourself, would you actually forgive this person? Would you actually want that this person's his deeds, his karma should be excused, can be erased, you know, he should be forgiven. Yeah, according to the law of karma, he should be forgiven and he should be allowed to get all good things in life. The moment I ask this question, everybody says, no, Preeti, he should pay for what he has done in his life. And he did that for 30 years. He did that to so many people in those 30 years. Then how can just a little bit of maybe some worshipping in a temple or some prayer in some faraway temple should take away his sin? He never did that. He never forgave anybody, though they were from a faraway place. Then how can he be forgiven for what he has done? How can his karma be forgiven? So the same thing applies to karmas. Karmas are something that you cannot erase. You have to erase them by paying them off. So karmas are something. When you do a negative karma, you are in the most ignorant sense of mind. And you may also be the most arrogant. And you know, you may not have that much wisdom. Because if you had that wisdom, you would have never done that karma. So when you are off your mind, you create some of the karmas. And the people who are innocent, people who are like innocent, they have not done anything wrong, you are hurting them whenever anybody does a bad karma. So the same thing applies to you. In the next birth, you are going to be born really innocent, and somebody is going to come and hurt you in the same way have you hurt them in the past birth. The person who comes and hurts you will be the same, it will be arrogant in the same way, will be ignorant, devoid of wisdom in the same way like how you were. So that thing is going to just be very rightful that it happened to you. So now your question might be, okay, but your video's title says how to heal the karma. So give us the tips about that. So let me tell you, see, there are no tips, there are no techniques, there is no kind of healing therapy that can actually heal your karmas. But what you can do is just first thing is you can forgive yourself for whatever you did. Second thing, pray to God that you don't want to do that karma again. You don't want to do any bad karma again, and you will need His help. That is a must do, because even if some bad karma happened by you, somewhere or the other, it was His wish that you go through that bad karma, and then later on in some other birth you realize that you shouldn't have done that. So when you want to stay devoid of bad karma, it is essential that you pray to God. The third thing is you need to change your habits. You need to change your habits. See, a karma isn't caused by it can be caused by unknowingly, without intent. That is not actually a bad karma, but a bad karma is what you continuously do intentionally. Maybe your intention is not to hurt that person, but somebody is getting hurt because you are doing that repeated action. Repeated action becomes a habit. Okay, so you need to first change your habits, change your actions. There is no other way to this, okay? You need to change your habits, develop positive habits, and ask for forgiveness. Whenever you feel you have done something wrong, just go and ask for forgiveness. You know, it takes like repeated efforts, like 1,000 efforts, like in a day you might have to do, so that you actually forcefully change your habits, forcefully change your path of karma. And yes, because you know, if any karma is created in the past life, it's going to be like very, very rigidly embedded inside your mind and soul. It will be difficult to overcome that. So yeah, taking God's help, asking for God's help, praying to God, at the same time being very, very strongly, yeah, you need to be very, very strongly determined that you need to just get off that karmic habit. Only then you will be able to get over, okay? You'll be able to get over that karmic pattern. So yeah, so this is the video about how you can overcome karmic habits, okay? Karma cannot be healed, but yes, they can be overcome. So this is it. Let me know in the comments, how did you like this video? And if you feel that this video is going to help a lot of people, do share this video with as many people as you can. I will see you again in my next video. Until then, keep following the path of your soul's purpose, because you are born for a reason. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.
Make sure that you subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon. When you click on the bell icon, select all notifications so that you get notified about all the videos that I upload.